Does this sound like you? You have more work to get done than you have hours in a given week to accomplish all of your tasks. And you just need to find a way to automate some of those repetitive tasks to free you up to work on things that are more important. A quick note here. This video is part of a challenge that I host in my school group to help the community members get some quick wins. If you would like to see the full series of videos and additional handouts, you can join my school community by following the link in the description below. In this lesson for the challenge, we're going to talk about how to take Microsoft Forms data and send it to lists using Power Automate. Now, in the prior lesson, we did talk about how you can add information directly to a list using a built-in forms feature. But those built-in forms aren't as robust as what you'll find in the standalone app. So I've navigated to the actual forms application, and here you can see that there are different question types that are not available directly in lists. And the other key difference is when you go to settings, you'll see a lot more options, especially related to who can respond. So instead of being stuck with one setting, you have the ability to choose anybody can respond and specific people. Now, the other reason I'd like to touch on for why you might want to use Power Automate instead of the built-in feature is with the built-in forms, you have the Notify Me button letting you get an email every time a form is submitted. But what if you need to notify somebody else or multiple people? Power Automate can handle that for you. Okay, so now let's look at the setup process, and there are two things that you're going to need before you can create the Power Automate flow. You'll need a form and a list. So for the form, I just went to the template gallery and pulled in this course evaluation survey and then just modified it a little bit. So we're going to pretend like we want to take this information and then analyze it a little bit so that we can improve our courses, right? And then as I scroll through, you can see that there are some different question types. Like this is a single line of text field. This is a choice field, multi-line of text. We've got some rating questions. So it's a good sample of the different question styles that you can move over to lists. And then now I've opened the list that I built to correspond to the questions in the survey. And I found that keeping the questions in the same order as the survey really makes it a lot easier when you're trying to match the form to the list in Power Automate. And then you should also have the columns be something related to the question as well. And sometimes I know that the form comes after the list. So, you know, just think about how you're going to map those things together. Now, when it comes to column headers and the questions, the column headers are often a lot shorter. So I'm going to show you a trick that I use to make the mapping easier. So when I create the columns, I like to go in and paste the actual question. And you'll see here in a little bit why this makes it easier, because having this as the full column name is just way too much. All right, so now that you see that we have a Microsoft form with 12 questions and we have a list with 12 fields that match it, we're ready to set up the flow. Now, just to be clear, your list can have more information than the form, but to keep it simple, I just made sure that they were identical. Now it's time to build our workflow with Power Automate, and I want to make sure that everybody knows how to find it. So open your web browser and go to the Microsoft 365 Copilot homepage. And then on the left-hand side, you'll see this section called Apps. When you click on that, at the very top, you'll see a sample of some of the most common apps that people use. Then you click on All Apps. And you'll scroll to the P section because these are alphabetized, and you can select Power Automate. Now that we're on the Power Automate homepage, we can create what Microsoft calls a flow, which is just another word of saying the automation. So in the navigation on the left-hand side, I'm gonna click on Create, and then we're gonna select Automated Cloud Flow. And basically what that means is Power Automate is listening for a specific thing to happen before it follows your instructions. The first thing that I'm going to do is give the flow a name. And as a tip, I like to have the flow and whatever process I'm managing have a matching name just to make it easier for me to tie all the resources together in my mind. Now we need to tell Power Automate what to listen for, and this is called a trigger. In this case, it's when a new response is submitted to Microsoft Forms, and it happens to be the top one on the list. So I'm going to select that, and then we're going to click Create. This is going to open up the Power Automate canvas so that you can start adding in the details of your flow. So right off the bat, it's telling us that there are invalid parameters. And the reason it's saying that is we haven't told it what form to listen to yet. So each of these boxes is called a card. When I click on this card, it's going to open up a pane on the left where I can enter in the information. What we need is a form ID so that Power Automate knows which form to pay attention to. When you click the dropdown, the forms that appear are personal forms, meaning that they are associated with your OneDrive. As we've discussed before, information tied to a business process should not be saved in OneDrive because that information will be deleted when the employee who created the form leaves the company. Therefore, I created a group form. To tell Power Automate it needs to look for that group form, go to the bottom of the dropdown and select Enter Custom Value. Then you will paste the form ID, which is actually called Design ID in Forms. If you don't know how to find the Design ID, I have a short video linked below. Now that we've entered the ID, it's time to add the next step. The steps in a flow are called actions. So when I click on this little plus sign here below the card, it opens up the pane again on the left and it says, okay, add an action. What do you want to do? When it comes to Microsoft Forms, it's not enough to tell Power Automate to say, hey, wait for a response to be submitted. The next thing you have to do is tell it to extract those responses. So I'm going to type in forms at the top of the search pane to narrow down the list of actions that I can choose. And you see under Microsoft Forms that the only action that's available is Get Response Details. So once I add that, I'm going to do the exact same thing I did with the trigger, and I'm going to copy and paste in the form ID. The next thing that Power Automate needs is the unique identifier for the response that was just submitted. Now, the response ID is not something that you're just going to automatically know. We're going to pull that in through dynamic content by clicking on this little lightning bolt at the right side of the field. And then the only option you have is response ID. Now that we've done all of that, the next step that we need to tell Power Automate what to do with the information that it's gathered up. So I'm going to click on the plus button again for add an action. And now we're going to tell it to send this information to our Microsoft list. Now, Microsoft list happens to be part of SharePoint. So if we search for the SharePoint connector and you click see more, you can see that there's a lot of choices here. What we're looking for is create an item because every entry onto a list is considered an item. So now Power Automate is going to ask us, well, where does this list live? And in this case, I have tied it to my SharePoint site associated with my masterclass. Once you've done that, you'll click the list name dropdown to see only those lists that are associated with this SharePoint site. And in this case, it's the course evaluation survey, because once again, I'm keeping all of the names the same to make it easier to tie all the pieces together. Now, Power Automate is not going to automatically know where to put each of the responses within the list. You have to tell it. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to open up advanced parameters, and then I'm going to start telling it where the information goes, which this is why I said earlier that the trick that I like to use is even though the column name might be a little bit different, I put the full question in the description to help me match them up. Now, the first column of any list is always going to be called title, and even if you rename it, it's still going to be called title in Power Automate. So in this case, I'm going to go into the dynamic selection and use the search bar to narrow it down to the question, what course did you participate in? And so now Power Automate knows to extract the response from that question in the form and copy it to the title field in the list. And we're just going to rinse and repeat these steps until we have mapped every question to a column in our Microsoft list. Now, I want to point out something when it comes to the achieved learning outcome question. This is a choice question which Power Automate is recognizing the answers, but we don't know what the person is going to say, and we don't want to hard code an answer into the automation. Instead, we're going to say enter custom value, and this will open up the option to use dynamic content to pull in the answer. The next thing I'd like to point out is this instructor performance question. In the form, it's actually a scale of 1 to 10, and lists doesn't have an equivalent column type. So I found that the easiest way to match up the form and the list is to use a single line of text in lists. I quickly matched up the rest of the questions to the list, so you don't have to watch me do that. Now, technically, the flow is done. It has everything it needs: a trigger telling it what to listen for, an action telling it to gather up the details, and an action telling it to copy those details to Microsoft Lists. However, at the beginning, I did mention that there is one more piece to this use case, and that's the option to send an email notification to one or more people beyond yourself. We're going to click on the plus sign for add an action again, and this time we're going to search for Office 365 Outlook. And the reason I'm choosing this one specifically is it's tied to your work email address. If you were to search for just Outlook, then all of the connectors would be pointing to a personal email address such as Hotmail or the new Outlook.com. From the Office 365 Outlook section, we're going to select Send an Email V2. We have to provide three mandatory pieces of information: who is the email going to, what is the subject line, and what is the content in the body of the email. So we're going to start with who does it go to. When you start typing in names, you're basically seeing results that are coming from your company's global address list, and you can add one or more people. In the subject line, you can type something that will be standard for every single email. You can use dynamic content or a combination of both. I typically use both. So in this example, I'm saying a new response was submitted to, and then I'm pulling the information from the title column to dynamically enter the name of the course. In the body of the email, you do have to put in at least a few characters, but you can enter as little or as much information as is necessary for your business process. But for this example, I just typed in a standard message. And now we have all the information that we need for the send an email action, as well as all of the information we need for the use case of this particular flow. Now I'm going to go to the toolbar on the upper right side of the screen and click Save. Now Power Automate is going to do a quick check to look for any basic errors. If it doesn't find any, you'll see a green bar at the top that says your flow is ready to go. Now keep in mind that Power Automate is not going to catch every error, especially ones that you may have made, such as putting in the wrong email address in the Send an Email V2 action. So I always test every flow to make sure that it does what I expected it to do. To do that, we're going to go back to the toolbar on the right and select Test. Then we're going to select Manually. You can't use automatically the first time because there's no information associated with this flow. Go to the bottom of the screen and click the word test. And then I navigated over to Microsoft Forms so that I could submit an answer as if I were one of the students who had participated in this class. Once I fill out all the information, all I have to do is click Submit, and that's the trigger that Power Automate is looking for. From a Power Automated resources perspective, this was a really easy flow. So by the time I navigated back, the test was already complete. And you can see that there are green check marks next to each of the steps, indicating that everything worked as intended. But I'm going to take this one step further, and I'm going to go over to Lists to verify that all of the information made it to each of the columns. Then I'm going to go over to Outlook and verify that the email was actually sent. I didn't find any errors, so the test was successful and the flow is ready to use. Now, some of you told me that you find it easier when we review all of the steps of the flow after it's been created. So here we go. We started with the forms trigger of when a new response was submitted, and then we added in the group form ID so that Power Automate knows what form to listen to. Then we added the action get response details and used the same form ID, but then also told Power Automate pull the details from the specific response that triggered this flow. We added the next action, which is create an item on a SharePoint list. And then we said what SharePoint site the list was on and the name of the list. From there, we went into advanced parameters and we mapped each of the form questions to its corresponding list column. And as an extra bonus step, we decided that we wanted to send an email to specific people whenever a response was submitted. And we did that with the send an email V2 connector for Office 365. And for that connector, all we needed to do was add in the names of the people who should receive the email, a subject line, and a message. And that's the entire flow. Hey, YouTube friends, I'm back to speak to you guys specifically. I hope this preview of the more detailed information that I offer in my Skool group will help you get a quick win and save some time as well. And if you'd like to join the challenge, as of the day this video is published, it's just kicking off and you can go over to my Skool group and join for free. Now, full transparency, I am going to ask for your email because I use that as a mechanism to help keep the spammers and the bots out. All right. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.